Breaking news tonight, the Pope in America. A rousing welcome for the man who's been called the Rockstar Pope. Rockstar Pope Francis begins a historic visit.
The two leaders will speak to the world, then hold a one-on-one meeting with only translators in the room, all before Pope Francis addresses Congress Thursday with Biden in attendance. Even though the president and the Pope are allies on issues ranging from climate change to income inequality to Cuba, even the Iran nuclear deal, the White House refuses to reveal what the two men will discuss.
For the faithful who'd been waiting for hours, the emergence of Pope Francis shortly before 9 a.m. was the thrill of a lifetime. Thousands, led by the President and Mrs. Obama, waited to greet him. And after the official welcoming ceremony, both leaders addressed the significance of the visit.
And I believe the excitement around your visit, Holy Father, must be attributed not only to your role as Pope.
And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth. And he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness. And I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet-colored beast full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and ten horns. And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand, full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication. And upon her forehead was a name written: Mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. And when I saw her, I wondered with great admiration.
We need to remember that we are followers of Jesus Christ. And his life, humanly speaking, ended in failure. The failure of the cross. The failure of the cross.
Moment. Pope Francis alone praying. He placed a rose atop the etched names of the 3,000 victims of the 9/11 attacks. His goal? Bringing people together. The pontiff chose this place to promote worldwide peace. The Pope joined hundreds of leaders of different faiths to talk about healing. Together, he led a prayer of peace for a violent world.
Peace in the hearts of all men and women, and peace among the nations.
He says he witnessed Pope Francis gracefully combining two contrasting passions in his effort to bring all religions together. To bring all religions together. The words may sound different, but the Pope gathered them into one voice for peace.
Papa Francesco, on behalf of this very distinguished group, representatives of the Hindu, Buddhist, Jain, Sikh, Native American, Jewish, Islamic, and Christian communities of New York City, our civic and public officials, and the board of the September 11th Memorial Foundation, I renew to you our welcome and our joy at your visit. Welcome, Holy Father.
Thank you. We, representatives of the world religions in this great city of New York, gather to offer words of comfort and
intolerance
prayer.
And ignorance fueled those who attacked this place. The courage of today's gathering distinguishes us from the opponents of religious freedom as we stand together.
Namo Buddhaya Jayang Virang Pasavati Dukkhang Seti Parahat.
Homage to the Buddha. Victory begets enmity.
Not the coat that we wear. That truth is above everything, and the highest deed is truthful living.
Makari iptohi to pnevmati, oti afton estin I vasilia ton uranon.
For they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are the
And there came one of the seven angels which had the seven vials, and talked with me, saying unto me, Come hither, I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of her fornication. So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness. And I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet-colored beast, full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and ten horns. And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand, full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. And when I saw her, I wondered with great admiration.
It's awesome to have you around. I'm glad you're addicted to fighting tyranny. Great job. 30 seconds left. Anything else?
Yes, I would like to just end with this note. As far as all the things that have happened while the Pope has been visiting here, the thing that bothered me the most is when he said Christ failed on the cross. And I did a report earlier in the day. People can go look at why I reference certain scriptures. But Christ didn't fail on the cross. He knew he was going to die on the cross. And he said, I'm giving myself willingly. So I was very disturbed to hear something like that.
He said that? I didn't know that. That was Christ's ultimate triumph.
Yeah. And he said he failed on the cross. As an ABC News, I'm sure it's on multiple
sounds
other
like something
news
the devil
well.
Would say, Jakari. Thank you.
Holy Spirit, be God.
This charismatic renewal has indeed been a source of personal renewal for individuals and an impetus for renewal within the church itself.
I began to experience a tremendous joy in my priesthood.
What was happening among Catholics got the attention of Cardinal Leon Joseph Sunens, a key architect of the Second Vatican Council. On Pentecost Sunday in 1975, Cardinal Sunens and 10,000 individuals who had this charismatic experience met with Pope Paul VI.
Long life for the charismatics.
Praise God! Amen!
Amen.
Tonight happen to be Baptists, Catholics, Episcopalians, Lutherans, Orthodox, Mennonites, Messianic believers, denominational Pentecostals, Presbyterians, United Methodists, non-denominational people, and many, many more. You see, for the world to believe depends on our becoming one.
The people of God have come together in one prophetic action to proclaim within the church. In many ways, unity is already here, and fuller unity is coming.
And we are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, and we proclaim to the world, we make one statement tonight, we are here because we are one in the Spirit.
He's brought it to advance his program, which is to make us one as he and the Father are one.
Christ in you is the hope of glory.
We know that we are called to be one body. We know that we are called to be one as the Father and Son is one. We know that a spirit of unity, the Holy Spirit of God, has been given to us, and that spirit won't rest until we're one. And we can count on that.
Catholic Charismatic Renewal Services. ECRIS was approved by the Holy See as a private association of the faithful with a juridical personality. It operates under the direction of the Pontifical Council for the Laity. Its purpose is threefold: promote the central goals of the Catholic Charismatic Renewal all over the world, promote unity among the varied realities and expressions of the Catholic Charismatic Renewal, has established dialogue and cordial relationships with other ecclesial movements and communities within the Catholic Church and with other ecclesial communions and Christian churches. In 1998, ECRIS, with other lay movements, helped the Pontifical Council for the Laity organize an international gathering of lay movements. Over 300,000 people gathered. Since 1967, over 120 million Catholics in over 220 countries in the world have experienced this refreshment of the Holy Spirit.
There's going to be some amazing stuff. For instance,
praise and worship.
Praise and worship, the best thing in the world.
Adoration.
Adoration, worshiping Jesus in the presence of the Eucharist.
Confession.
Oh, get rid of those sins.
Mass.
The sacrifice of the Mass.
Vespers.
Vespers. Do you even know what Vespers are? Come find
Did
out.
Did we say praise and worship?
Did we say praise and worship? Music is the praise best way. And praise and worship like you've never done before.
And he's a friend.
And he's a friend.
And he's a friend of mine. He's a good friend of mine.
Because he made that Jesus walks. And
I'm mad at that. I'm mad at Jesus for not giving me that joint.
Yeah, I know.
I've been walking with you. Your boy been walking with you for a minute. You could have let me have that record, son. So come on, son. Come on, Jesus could have gave me that record.
That he's going to name his next album Jesus. It sounds like Jesus. It could mean ye, because they call him ye. It's one of us, Jesus. Or it could be a play on the word Jesus. Some people feel like that's blasphemy. Blasphemous. How do you feel about that? How do you feel about that if he wanted to name his album Jesus?
Well, what I would say to, you know, him or to anyone is that my relationships with people give me opportunities to share with them, and I don't always consider it wise. I think that the microphone is a very powerful tool, mm-hmm. and you can use it to build people up or you can use it to kill people. Mm-hmm. And so if my job on earth is to always try to be a light in somebody's life, then I would want to use the tool in order to be able to communicate in a way that if I'm going to uplift someone, mm-hmm. then I may not always do it through this tool, mm-hmm. which is the microphone. You know, that may be just heart to heart and breast to breast. It may be over a cup of, you know, coffee. You know, mm-hmm. it may be a phone call when I see somebody in person. I'm not one to believe that people that have been blessed with opportunity microphones, that the microphone is used, that is needed for your view to always be used at that time. Mm-hmm.
Soul to the devil.
And he's a friend.
And he's a friend.
And he's a friend of mine. He's a good friend of mine.
Because he...
I mean, whatever thoughts I have about Kanye or, you know, or, you know, same-sex marriage or anything else, I've chosen to be able to walk out life with people, you know?